In this module, we'll be talking about the basics of WPA and WPA2 hacking. So as we know, in the year 1999, web was implemented in the market, and within some time, web was broken. So any router which was implementing web could be easily hacked within 5 to 10 minutes. So IEEE decided to build much more robust and stronger standard. However, if they would have built a very strong standard, then hardware changes were required. But during that time, a lot of people had already bought the web-based router. So what they decided to do is they decided to make a temporary solution which was called WPA. One of the advantages of WPA was hardware change was not required. However, disadvantages, it is not very secure. WPA stands for Wi-Fi Protected Access, and it was built on top of web. However, it used TKIP along with the RC4. So the people who were using web-based routers, they just had to upgrade their firmware and they would have got WPA. So WPA is still not hacked, but there are a lot of attacks which are targeting WPA nowadays. So as it was a temporary based solution, after WPA, IEEE built WPA2, which was a long time solution. And this is what we use in most of the routers nowadays. One of the disadvantages of WPA2 was hardware change was required. So all the routers during the old times which had web would need to be changed in order to support WPA2. So all the new routers, they come pre-configured with WPA2. One of the significant changes was WPA2 used AES along with CCMP. So TKIP and RC4 were scrapped, and newer and much more better encryption algorithm were implemented. It is considered very secure, and WPA2 nowadays does not have a proper vulnerability through which it can be hacked easily. So one of the ways where WPA2 can be hacked is when a client connects to a Wi-Fi access point which is based on WPA or WPA2, there occurs a four-way handshake with the router. If we manage to capture this four-way handshake, then we can run a dictionary or a brute force attack on that handshake in order to recover the key file. Now the catch is that we have to run either dictionary or we can also use brute force type of attacks. Now the problem with that is it can take from minutes to even years to crack, and some of them can not be even cracked in a lifetime. So unlike web, where our main focus was to capture a lot of unique IVs which were generated by the data packets, so we were able to do it within 5 to 10 minutes. However, WPA and WPA2 networks works a lot differently. So suppose you have a WPA2 password with 63 characters long, right? Alphanumeric special characters, then it would be virtually impossible to hack that WPA2 based network. So if we look into the computational part, a 25 character password with alphanumeric and possible symbols also might take even hundreds of years to crack. So our only hope is that the client or the victim is using weak password, and that is the only thing that we expect. So if the victim is not using weak password and is using a very strong password, then it would be impossible to directly attack the WPA or WPA2 based networks.